Presented by Chrysler, the name that makes news in watchmen. How did the moon threaten the world by twisting children's minds? Tonight, Tales of Tomorrow presents Many Happy Returns. Starring Gene Raymond. Now, maybe you can hold your watch underwater safely, too. After all, waterproof watches are no news today, but what about your watch band? After all, what good's a watch that's waterproof if your watch band isn't? And Chrysler has the answer. The new Crescent watch band by Chrysler is your best bet when it's wet. Rain, water, perspiration, you can depend on the Crescent to look like new and to flex like new. Now, I'd like to show you the styling Chrysler has created for this exclusive watch band that's a must if you own a waterproof watch. And you know, whether your watch is waterproof or not, if it's the popular round style, then you must see the new Chrysler watch band that's specially designed for round watches. Look how perfectly the curved links blend with the shape of the watch. Notice how the round ends match the curve of a round watch on both sides. And notice specially how the curved design of the end pieces eliminates any ugly gap at this point, makes the band look custom-made for the watch. See how every link of the crescent follows the curve of the watch and becomes a part of the watch, making it one smart, continuous piece of jewelry. It's the greatest new idea in men's watch bands in years. It's the new Crescent watch band by Chrysler. And practical? This Chrysler band expands to bring you new convenience and comfort. You can thank Chrysler's super-calibrated seven-coil springs. And Crescent by Chrysler costs only $7.50 in stainless steel or only $10.95 with gold-filled top, federal tax included. So, if you own a round watch, go to your jeweler tomorrow and buy Crescent, the first and only watch band in the world that's exactly right for the round watch. Make your watch look better than new and dress up your appearance, too, with Chrysler. And now Chrysler presents Many Happy Returns, starring Gene Raymond.
Sure that thing goes right there?
Yeah, sure, Dad. That's where it goes.
Mm-hmm. What happens after the switch?
Nothing, Dad. That's it.
Hmm. Haven't you forgotten the wires that feed the electricity to the switch?
Nope.
Look, son. A switch is used for making or breaking the connections in an electrical circuit. What's the point of having a switch if you have no power to feed through it? Hmm?
This is right, Dad.
How's the machine going to work unless you've got power? Hmm? No source of power? Let me show you. This switch here...
Don't touch it!
I wasn't going to touch it.
I'm sorry, Dad. I didn't mean to yell.
It ain't going to work, son.
Oh, it'll work, Dad. Mr. White's got it all figured out.
Mr. White again, huh? Dean minutes till dinner, son.
Jack! Andy!
Yes! Happy anniversary, Don.
Not till midnight. Jack coming up?
Well, I'm afraid we're going to have to give the mad scientist another 15 minutes or so.
Oh, no, we don't. He gets lost down there. Jack, come on up and wash now.
Just a minute, Mom, please.
Honestly, what he does to keep himself busy in that cellar hour after hour is beyond me.
Beyond me, too, electrically speaking, that is. Jane, you know of a handyman around here by the name of White?
White? No, I don't think so. Dr. Barnes has a handyman. He cuts the lawn, does our jobs. Julius something or other. I don't know what his last name is.
It might be him. Oh, speaking of the devil. Hiya, Doc. Go on in.
Hello, Jane.
Good evening, Doc.
Andy. Andy, come over here.
Look. Full moon coming up. Light clouds at 18,000 feet, and by 8:30, we'll have unlimited visibility.
Yeah, it looks pretty good, huh?
We're concentrating on the upper right quadrant of the moon tonight.
You know, it's beyond me. Why, two grown men, would want to spend their evenings peeking through a telescope at
Jane,
the moon.
Jane, I'm surprised at you. Astronomy is the oldest science known to man.
Oh. By the way, Doc, do you know the last name of your handyman?
Julius, I don't know. I just call him Julius.
Could it be White?
I don't think so.
Well, do you know of a handyman or electrician or maybe an engineer in the neighborhood by the name of White?
White.
Well, it's not important.
Well, then, observation period begins promptly at 8:30.
Oh, don't worry, Doc. I'll be there.
By the way, bring your lenses with you.
Yeah, I won't forget. So long, Doc. See you later.
Oh, now this has to stop. Jack?
Yes, Mom?
Come up this minute right now.
Now, Jack, you don't want me to come down and get you, do you?
It's about time. Are you washed? It's a good thing for you that you are. You're as bad as he is. Down in the cellar the minute you get home. Outdoors only when it's dark. You're both beginning to look like a couple of mushrooms.
Hey, that's pretty gruesome. It's about time. Did you get it all finished?
Uh-huh.
Does it work?
Uh-huh.
Are you sure?
Of course, Dad. I fixed it just the way Mr. White told me to. It works fine. Just fine.
Late again. Well, I've forgotten something. I can't remember what it is.
I know. Your whatchamacallit.
My lenses. Sure, let me see. Where did I put them?
Oh, no.
The cellar. Oh, just like a steel trap.
Just like a steel trap.
Thing.
Get your father a glass of water. Oh, Andy, I'll call the doctor.
No, I'll be all right. Just let me sit here a minute.
You're going to be all right, aren't you?
There was enough power in that thing.
to electrocute me.
Gee, I'm real sorry.
You mean the thing Jack was building did this to you?
How did you know how to build it?
Mr. White, I told you.
Now, who is this Mr. White?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? You've spoken to him. He told you how to build it, didn't he?
Yes, he did, but I didn't exactly talk to him.
You didn't talk to him?
No, I didn't have to. You see, whenever I want to know something, I mean about building the machine. He tells me.
He tells you? How? Where?
He just tells me, that's all.
Now, Jack, where do you meet him?
I've never met him. Not the way you mean.
How does he tell you things?
He talks to me. I can hear him. Inside my head.
Now, Jack, I'm not going to be angry with you if you tell me the truth. But I want you to tell me, where do you meet Mr. White?
I told you I'd never met him. Just one night I was lying in bed, and I looked out the window, and I heard him. He was there.
There? Where?
In the moon.
Jack, this is serious. Your father told you not to be afraid to tell him anything.
In the moon? You mean you saw him?
No, I didn't see him. I heard him. He talked to me. He said he wanted me to make something for him.
Wanted you to make that thing?
That's right.
Well, go on. Now, how did his voice sound?
Soft, as if he were very close to me, right in the room.
He tells you what to get and how to put it together? Does he ever talk to you about anything else except what you're making?
Sometimes he says that someday he'll see me. He'll come here, from the moon. He's all alone there.
Jane.
Jack, what's the machine for?
It's a way for him to send me things.
And when you get it finished, he'll send you something?
He's already sent me something. I told you it worked. I was just making some changes so that he could... Well, they were improvements.
You mean he's already sent you something?
Would you mind telling us what it is?
It's a picture of himself. I wanted to know what he looked like, and I thought it might be nice if I had a picture of him.
You mean... You can ask him for things?
Well, not exactly ask him. I think about it, and he knows what I'm thinking. I had explained what a picture was. I mean, tell him about the camera and the film and everything. And then he sent me a picture.
Jack, would you mind showing us the picture?
No, you can see it.
Leave the world of the future and recall for the moment a tale of the past. You all remember the story of the ugly duckling, the poor little ugly duckling that nobody liked. And then one day, he was changed into the most beautiful swan. Nature makes some magic transformations, and so does Chrysler. Here, for example, is the ugly duckling of watch bands. The old-fashioned black cord that hardly flatters your watch no matter how modern its design. And then, lo and behold, the touch of Chrysler's new fantasy watch band magically transforms your watch into a lovely bracelet watch. Best of all, instead of spending $50 or more for this style, you pay only $9.95 for Chrysler's new fantasy watch band. Here, take a close look at this sensational new watch band. It's the new slim fantasy band that fits even a very small watch and makes it high fashion and a true bracelet watch. Ask for it by name. It's Golden Fantasy by Chrysler. You can have Golden Fantasy in a variety of styles, jewel set or tailored, to suit your taste. And whatever model you pick, See how perfectly it suits your watch. See how perfectly this new design at the end blends with the smallest watch. Another big advantage, these bands expand. So when you're doing work around the house, you can slip Fantasy up out of the way. And remember, Golden Fantasy costs less than many ordinary bands, only $9.95, federal tax included. So go to your jeweler. Make your old watch look smarter than new with the Fantasy Watch Bracelet by Chrysler. And now back to our story, Many Happy Returns, starring Gene Raymond.
Jack, this isn't anything human.
Darling, darling, where did you get this picture?
From the machine, Mom. Mr. White sent it to me.
Now, stop calling it Mr. White. That's the name of something human. This isn't anything human.
I wasn't doing anything wrong.
I know you weren't, Jack. You better go to your room now. Don't worry, I won't touch it again. And neither will you.
Maybe he got that picture out of some magazine or book. You know, one of those fake pictures.
No, I don't think it's a fake.
Well,
I think he... somehow he did get it from something out there.
Andy, that's impossible.
That's not so impossible. We'll be able to send things to the moon one of these days. They've already invented explosives that'll send rockets outside the atmosphere. Apparently this Mr. White has got something better. An immense electrical discharge... enough to wallop something 239,000 miles with the accuracy of a bomb sight. Oh, it's a tall order. But it could be done. Well, it has been done.
But how does he talk to him?
He must stimulate the auditory centers of his brain somehow. Mental telepathy. Hundreds of thousands of miles of space. This isn't much of an anniversary for you, is it?
Could this thing hurt him?
It hasn't yet. But if it came here...
Andy, he said it would come here.
Well, sending a picture is one thing, but making the trip itself...
Didn't Jack say he was making some changes, going to make some kind of improvement on it?
Yes.
He would come here, in our house.
I did it exactly the way you told me to. I didn't make any mistakes. And you'll come soon, won't you? Dad's awfully angry, Mr. White. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to tell him anything. You wouldn't hurt him, would you?
He's talking to you, isn't he? Isn't he? Now, Jack. Jack, this thing out there, whatever it is, it doesn't mean you any good. It doesn't mean any of us any good. I can sense it. It's as though something had crawled across my face in the middle of the night.
Dad, don't talk like that. Don't talk about Mr. White. Don't even say a word against him.
All right, son, I won't say anything against him, but tell me this. You were working on the machine making some sort of improvement, you said. What kind of an improvement, Jack?
No.
Now, Jack, tell me, please. Now, was this improvement so that Mr. White could come down to Earth through it? Was that it?
I can't tell you. I can't tell you.
Jack, come here. Jack!
I can't tell you.
Jack, you used to talk to me before about Mr. White. Why not now?
He won't let me.
What do you mean he won't let you? He can't stop you, can he?
Dad, please.
Can he?
How?
What's the matter? Well, can't you talk? He won't let you? Now, Jack, you look at me.
You keep looking at me. He can't stop you from talking. I'm here. I'm your father. I love you and I want to protect you. Do you understand? Now, he's reaching out across those hundreds of thousands of miles and touching your brain with his will. But my will's stronger, Jack, because I love you. Do you understand that? All right, now, he can stop you from speaking, but he can't stop you from telling me what I want to know, can he? Can he? All right, now, this improvement. Was this so that Mr. White could come here? Was it so he could send you something else, something larger? Was it so you could send him something? Send him something? What did he want? Don't you know? He hasn't told you? Jack, what if I smash the machine? Will that help us? Jack, is yours the only machine besides the one he might have? There are others? Where are they? Are they here in the town? Who has them? Friends of yours? Friends of yours? So that's it. It's worked through the children.
I called Dr. Barnes' house, but his wife said he was out with the club. Andy, what's wrong?
Mr. White. He's got hold of the boy's mind. Wrapped himself around his brain so he can't talk to us.
Oh, no. No.
Okay, take it easy. Take it easy. Jane, don't leave him alone for a minute.
Where are you going?
There are other kids in the neighborhood. Kids who are making the same sort of machines as he is.
Andy, what does this mean?
I don't know. But if it starts like that, twisting and warping the minds of children, I'd be afraid to find out.
Oh, my baby. My baby.
Gosh, I didn't know Mr. Drew. Jack and a couple of the other kids have been building them.
Peter, are you able to send things through this machine to Mr. White?
Yes. Well, just a few things. He wanted anything we could find. I sent him a few things like a tape measure and an electric light bulb.
Pete, now tell me, how do you do it? How do you send things to him?
Well, you put what you want to send in a package, and you throw the switch and just hold it over the coil. And that's it. It goes.
Thanks, Pete. Thanks for everything.
Sandy, I don't understand.
Well, it's perfectly simple, darling. They taught me how to make this in the Army. It's a booby trap. Even some little as 4 ounces of pressure will set off the whole bundle. That means if it's bumped when it gets to Mr. White's machine, it'll go off. If he even picks it up incorrectly, it'll go off. You know, Jane, I don't think those other children realized what they were getting in for. They didn't know that they were being carefully controlled by this Mr. White until Jack came along. He was the only one with willpower enough to fight the thing. Evidently, that's why he can't talk. That thing in the moon, whatever it is, doesn't want him to talk. Might never let him talk again.
Oh, Andy,
now, that's
please,
why we
please.
Must try this thing. I don't know whether it'll work. Who knows whether it will? Who knows what'll happen when it goes off in the strange atmosphere of the moon? It might not even harm this Mr. White creature. But we've got to do something to try to bring Jack back to us.
Thank you.
missed it. You missed it.
What?
One of the great moments in the history of astronomical observation. I called the Hughes Observatory and they hadn't seen it.
Seen what?
They hadn't seen it.
Seen what, Doc?
An eruption. An eruption on the moon.
An eruption?
It was magnificent.
Jack!
Oh, Andy, Andy.
Jack, come downstairs.
What I wouldn't have given for a more powerful set.
Jack!
And a camera set up. But we were the first to report it. The first.
Yes, sir.
South Palomar Observatory.
I should have seen it, Doc.
The one night your husband couldn't come, he missed an explosion on the moon. I myself saw only the tail end of it, but it was a sight to behold. Truly a sight to behold. Well, aren't you sorry you missed it?
Yeah, I guess I am.
Of all the nights you could have chosen to waste at home, you had to miss this.
Mom. Dad.
Oh. I don't think the evening's been exactly wasted, Doc. Many happy returns, darling.
When you look for something different in watch bands, look for Chrysler. For example, this one with your own initials. Or when you're looking for a fine band at a thrifty price, as low as $4.95, you'll find many like this in the big selection of Chrysler watch bands. Yes, whether you're looking for a man's band or a lady's style, there's a Chrysler watch band to suit every watch, every taste, and every purse. At Jewelers Everywhere, Chrysler watch bands give you the finest selection, the finest value. So remember always, when you look for quality, look for Chrysler. What kept an Egyptian king alive in his tomb 4,000 years? What fate befell the discoverers of the secret? Next week, Tales of Tomorrow presents The Tomb of King Taras, starring Walter Abel. And now a word from Alan Edwards.
Tales of Tomorrow is brought to you next week by C.H. Maslin & Sons, makers of Maslin Beauty Blend Broadlooms and authentic hunting and fishing clothes. Now this is Maslin's Carousel, a lovely new high-pile broadloom woven of fine carpet rayons for rich, gay color and distinctive texture. Carousel comes in popular solid shades, modern tweed mixtures, and light dark tones that blend beautifully with any room setting. Only about $7.95 a square yard at your favorite store. Carousel, one of the famous beauty blend broadlooms by C.H. Maslin, your host next week on Tales of Tomorrow.
Jack Chrysler.
Jack Chrysler.
On my hand.
On your hand.
Initial just for me, and so it's my band.
It's your band. It's Chrysler.
It's Chrysler.
For me too.
For you too.
Makes your watch look better than new.
Quality, style, and value too. For the best band in the land. It's Chrysler. Makes your watch look better than new.
Makes it personal just for you.
It's Chrysler.